everybody, it's your boy Gaming Forte back at it with another video. Make sure you hit that like and subscribe button, it definitely helps out the channel a lot. And before we get into this video, don't forget about my last video where we talked about parity between the Xbox One X and the Xbox One S. This is something a lot of people had a lot of questions about, and these are my thoughts about it. So click that button that just popped up in the right hand side of the corner and you can check out my thoughts on it. And the subject of this video is going to be January's NPD, and those results have just been released. And before we get into the actual conversation around the NPD, let's just talk about who won. So Nintendo looks like they came out on top. They were the number one selling hardware in North America for the month of January. Coming in second place was the PlayStation platform, which had the highest dollar amount earned in the month of January from hardware sales. And last but not least, the Xbox One came in third place, where it actually boasted its highest earnings in sales and actual hardware pushed out in the month of January ever since they've been tracking NPD numbers in the United States for the Xbox platform. Now, the one great thing about this is sales were actually tracked within 3% of each other between Xbox, PlayStation, and Nintendo. So there was really no big winner. Everybody basically won this month. This is something that the analyst that they interviewed said is very unusual, and he doesn't expect this to go forward past March into the rest of this year. But let's talk about why I believe this is happening. First, I'm gonna say one thing. I'm a little shocked that the Nintendo Switch is still selling as well as it's selling right now. Now, I do know a lot of people probably weren't able to get their hands on one, but it's just real crazy that that system is still selling at the clip that it's been selling for the whole year. I mean, in the first 10 months, it sold 15 million systems, which is roughly about what half of Xbox sold in about 4 or 5 years. So that just lets you know that this system has no thoughts of ever slowing down, at least as of right now. Now, it's a little different with the PlayStation platform, and I'm truly not surprised by this. The Pro actually did take a discount when it came to the Star Wars bundle from $449 to $399, making it in line with all of the other PlayStation bundles that got released. And I honestly believe that Microsoft and the Xbox One X is one of the main reasons that the PlayStation 4 Pro is selling so well right now. Think about it. If you take the fact that Nintendo is leading in NPD for the month in hardware, but PlayStation is actually leading in the dollar amount, well, the Nintendo Switch is $299. The base PS4 is either $249 or $299 depending on when you get it during the month and what retailer you go to. The only way PlayStation can actually outsell Nintendo is by selling a higher end system, which means $399 for the PlayStation 4 Pro. Now, we don't know exactly how many PS4 Pros they actually sold, but I know a lot of people are seeing the narrative of the Xbox One X, and they're seeing that that system is way more powerful, and now everybody that has a base PS4 or a PlayStation 4 Slim is starting to want to jump on that bandwagon to say, hey, I want my games to run better too. So this is just competition. Microsoft brings out a better system. PlayStation is basically stand packed with their PS4 Pro, but the people that didn't have their PS4 Pro are starting to see massive gains in the games that are coming out. The conversation is really turning up on the different enhancements that all these games are getting. So I believe Microsoft definitely has a hand in why the PlayStation 4 Pro is doing well. And Sony, congratulations. At least you have that system on the market to actually take advantage of that, because if you didn't, a lot of those people might jump ship and come back to the Xbox platform. Now, talking about the Xbox platform, they have had, like I said, the number one January they've ever had in NPD, and I believe that's mostly due to the Xbox One X in the first January since it was released. The biggest thing that I take away from this is every system is doing well right now. They even talked about how the 3DS and the Classic Edition are actually seeing year-over-year sales increases, and that's something that normally doesn't happen. I believe part of the reason these people are going out and buying these consoles is the fact that it's tax season, so people have a little bit of extra money from the holidays. On top of that, the fact that graphics cards are seeing a huge inflation along with RAM, it's just not easy to actually just pay those prices that they want you to pay. I mean, a 1080 Ti right now is going for $1,500, which is double the price that it normally goes for. So just the approachability of PC gaming is just at an all-time low right now. Some people are getting into it if they're buying homemade and pre-built systems, but that's something that a lot of people normally don't do. This time of year is one of those times that you see people upgrading their hardware, and right now the best hardware you can buy is a console because it's efficient, it gets you close to 4K, it may not hit that 60 frames per second, but you do get the visual aspect that you normally don't get from a console with these new mid-gen refreshes. So ultimately, these are some of the things that I believe is contributing to the fact that these systems are selling really well. And honestly, I believe this is something that can really go on for a while. I really can see us going into March, April, and May and still still see consoles going up in sale prices every year, month over month, just for the simple fact that people are still going to be spending money from their taxes and everything like that. So before I close out this video, I just want to say this to you guys. Everybody right now is winning is a good thing. Microsoft is performing well, PlayStation's performing well, Nintendo's performing well, the industry as a whole is performing well. Gaming is at a really good place right now, and I think that this is something that we should be celebrating. But this is something I want to ask you. When you bought your system, did you buy your system to say, hey, I bought a system that wins NPD every month, or did you buy your system to say, hey, I want to play games on this system? And you know what? I'm gonna take a guess on this, because I believe most people that watch this video are the people that's gonna say, I bought my system to play games on it. And if you're one of those people, you should be happy that all the systems are doing well, because that just means that later down the line, your system of preference is gonna do something based on what the other platforms are doing to actually make your platform better. That's how gaming works. That's the number one thing we should look for, and that's the one thing we should be celebrating. And with that, guys, we're at the end of the video. So thanks for watching the video. Sub to the channel if you haven't. Like this video if you like the content. It definitely helps out the channel a lot. Turn on those notifications. It's gonna let you know the next time one of my videos go live. It's your boy Gaming Forte. You guys have a great week, and I'm gonna talk to you in the next video. Peace.